The first candidate would be David Wu.
Hello everyone. Although many of you may know me already, my name is David Wu. I really think you should consider voting me for president because I have more than enough credentials suited for the job. For one, I'm in honors in math, which means, growth is garbage. Oh my king, I'm just going to be fine. Now I'll level with you guys. I petitioned myself for president completely on a whim, with the idea that it's going to be my last year in high school, and that there's no harm in going for it. Although I'm running with the premise, it's senior year, prez or bust. It does not mean that I don't have my share of ideas for how our last year of high school should go about. With that out of the way, I'm sure you had your fill of candidates selling their personalities and character to get a position. However, I've already established that I'm not here to do that. I want us to use my turn to give results. Rather than choosing me as a candidate, I want you to choose my ideas as a set of goals for what kind of legacy we want to leave behind. Let's be honest, there are only a few things we can all actually look forward to. There aren't a whole lot of opportunities to make our years something worth remembering. This means we will want to put everything we've got into what few opportunities we have. The biggest of these is, of course, prom. I'm more than happy putting my own money into making this prom special. However, I'm not here to sugarcoat things, so chances are I'm also going to need your money. Be it from fundraisers like bake sales or elsewhere. Of course, this also applies to the other events that we'll be hosting, like Powder Puff or Color Fest, which unfortunately needs more money. I know a lot of us are salty because we're going to be the last class stuck inside this moldy rubble of a building, and that we won't be able to enjoy the many luxuries that Home Depot 2020 will offer our underclassmen. Yeah. However, instead of griping about missing out on all these benefits, we should look forward to our senior year as a chance to leave a mark on this school before it gets its long overdue facelift. I want our year to be something worth remembering. We should do everything in our power to leave an unbeatable legacy in Homedale. You know, by doing things that past grades would regret not thinking of doing and that coming years would aspire to surpass. Usually, that means having a big enough group of idiots humiliating themselves in public for attention. For which means, like, Powder Puff give us great opportunities for it. I, for one, am more than willing to do just that. So, if by some golly miracle enough of you accidentally pick the wrong candidate and I do get elected, I will do everything in my power to deliver the results both you and I desire. Thank you, and well, treasure.
Athlete stereotype that's been brought up and thrown into question as to I planned this out basically, like, I'm gonna explain, like, I planned this out from the beginning of my sophomore year. My plan was to begin as vice president so I could learn, like, what I need to do and what the qualifications for position are. I wanted to gel with the student council and get some experience so I could really be ready for this year's election. I feel like last year's vice presidency was a way for me to get great experience, and it has really put me towards the top in terms of qualifications for the position. So the stereotypes of the athlete running for a position and not knowing what they're doing can be entirely erased. I've also heard many questions regarding whether I'd be able to plan a good senior prom or not. To that, I say yes. This year's prom was good, it was fun, it was interesting. I feel like I'll definitely be able to produce a better senior prom with the help of my student council partners and our great advisor, Ms. Cemental. I think my ideas for senior prom will be able to produce a more beautiful and loved prom for senior year. I think both the candidates running against me are great, and their ideas should be listened to also. I'll be glad to listen to their opinions based on what they want next year when I get voted as president. Our senior prom is going to be a beautiful event, which I'll be able to produce along with the great people who I'll be working with. I'd also like to address another area of our presidency. There are people who I will obviously not specifically mention who do not want me to A, run for this position, and B, be in this position. There are people who try to discourage me from running for this position. By voting for me as president, you are showing that the best possible candidate wins the position. You are showing that the most open and creative mind wins the position, and your votes will be heard the most. I'm open to input from every single thing you guys want from any member of our grade. I hope that you use your votes in the best way to choose me as president, because that's the best choice for the future of the class 2018 and the best for the end of our high school lives.
Bullshit.
Much of my time,
money, and energy into this position, despite having numerous other responsibilities in my classes, clubs, and activities. I hope to continue my career as your president, and that all of my hard work will allow me to be the one to give a speech at our high school graduation, just as I did at our eighth grade graduation. The ability to act as this representative is not an easy task, but a task that I am dedicated to continue. I ask of you to consider this. Senior year is the last one we have. Do you want to take any chances or to ensure that you have someone who has worked endlessly and tirelessly for this class? Therefore, I ask you to please consider the hard work and passion I have poured into the class of 2019 and trust that I will make our senior year one to never forget. Thank you.
Okay, girl.